Shares of Trump Media and Technology Group, the parent company of Truth Social, plunged yesterday after a new SEC filing revealed the company lost more than $58 million in 2023. That compared to a $50.5 million profit in 2022. Donald Trump, who owns a majority of the newly public company, saw his own net worth tumble by more than $1 billion on paper.
Trump's personal wealth tumbling by more than $1 billion. By some estimations, way more than $1 billion in just one day. And I couldn't have asked for it to happen for a better reason than it did. That people figured out that Trump is a con man and that what he's selling is not worth what he says it is. And so he loses $1 billion. That's how the world should work. But anyway, as she alluded to, the media company that controls it went public. The stock price absolutely soared. And it took about a day for people to figure out that that had no relationship whatsoever to the actual value of the company, which meant that a fall was coming. And the fall, in fact, did come. Shares in the firm had plummeted by more than 15% just in the first few hours after that financial statement. Depending on when you're watching this, you can go take a look at the stock price. It's really varied, you know, back and forth from $48 per share. It had been at over 62. When we went live, it was at 52. And for those of you who don't own shares in the stock, you might think, well, what's the difference if it's 48 or 52? Well, Trump owns the majority of that stock, which means that price difference is hundreds of millions of dollars for him. So, you know, if you want, put up the stock ticker in a separate tab and occasionally check in. And as it drops, that's fun. Just a little hobby for you.
Before we continue with the story, we depend on members to keep on going. Don't wait. Click join now on YouTube.
In any event, as the stock price began to tumble, I am sure that Donald Trump was thinking it would be nice to sell right now while it still has some value. The issue is that he actually can't sell the stock. Take a look at this.
The other thing I want to note here, Donald Trump can't sell his stock right now. He's in what we call a lockup, which means that for the next 6 months, he's got to sit on those shares. There's a very real possibility that this stock tanks in that time and that when he does go to sell the shares, they're not worth anything. And so when all these people are saying, oh, well, Donald Trump's net worth is now billions of dollars. Well, let's see what happens in 6 months from now and what this company looks like.
Yeah, let's see. Let's see what happens to that stock price, because again, the valuation of it has no relationship whatsoever to what it's worth. I mean, look, you can come up with a scenario where in 5 or 10 years, somehow he figures out how to get people to go to one of the least popular social media sites in the world. You can try as an intellectual exercise to do that. But right now, it ain't worth jack squat. $58 million they lost, okay? Like, I don't know, my Patreon was profitable. Trump's one, his thing wasn't. Sabrina's Twitch stream was more profitable than TMTG Industries. Honestly, if you want to invest in something, invest in Sabrina's Twitch stream, because that will actually have a return on the investment. True Social will not. So I have a lot more to say about this, Sabrina, but I want to bring you in. The stock market's a hell of a thing, isn't it?
Oh boy, that's capitalism, baby. What a great system. But also, I don't know how many people were even taking Truth Media seriously to begin with. When you have joke stocks like this, you can't be surprised when the value of it fluctuates as rapidly as this does. So I kind of feel bad for maybe like the working class folks who were maybe influenced, like, oh yeah, this is a great idea. Invest in this stock. You're investing in our President Donald Trump. Yeah, it's a good thing. And now their money is going down the drain. Like, Trump will still be rich. He's gonna be fine. I don't think anything ultimately bad is going to happen to him, but there are going to be some poor saps out there who are also, going to be out their investment, and that sucks. So
yeah, it feels capitalism. A lot like 100%. It is. It feels like a crypto pump and dump, though. I'm sure, you know, as it soared up, a lot of like MAGA people were like, "Oh my God, this thing's going to the moon! I gotta get it." But it's not going to stay there. Like, some people are going to make money off of this. Whenever this sort of insane stuff happens, some people make money. Would you like to gamble that you're going to be one of those people? Because you know where they make their money from? The rest of the people. How would you like to fund some a-hole getting rich quick? You can do that. You can have a chance at that. But no, this makes no sense. To get a little bit technical, Trump Media has a 1,470 price to sales ratio. Okay, for comparison's sake, Reddit, one of the actual biggest social media sites on the internet, has a 9 price to sales ratio, 1470 to 9. Ask yourself a question. Do you know anyone on True Social? Do you know anyone that has ever been on True Social? I go on True Social. The only account I've ever looked at is Trump's. I have to for my job, which means that I come across the ads on True Social. And if you want to get an idea of what this stock is going to be worth, take a look at the people advertising on True Social. It's a hell of a thing. All of the ads are weird fungal things growing on old people's bodies. And maybe that's worth big money, I don't know. But it doesn't seem like it based on the ads that I'm seeing. So I expect that this is going to continue to drop. But don't ever take financial advice from me. I'm going to be Googling how to short stocks because I feel like some money could be made on the other side of this thing. But I expect that Donald Trump might find in 6 months when he's finally freed up to sell this thing that it's not worth nearly as much as he thought it would be. It will still, because the world sucks, be worth far more than it should be, but it ain't gonna be worth $3 billion. Any other thoughts, Sabrina, before we move on?
Do you think if Truth Social actually like goes down, Trump sells later in the future, do you think he'll go back to Twitter? Because remember, that was his big, big thing, Truth Social launch. And he's like, even though Twitter reinstated me, I'm not going back there. But it's like, you have to go back at some point, at some time, sir. And it's still the same dumpster fire website and it's getting worse and worse. So your demographic is going to be there. You're going to be fine if you end up having to go back to Twitter or X.
Yeah, and the demographic are going to be the, you know, the Trump ladies. He likes getting the retweets from them about how he's Jesus or something, and bots, all bots. AI generated messages with AI generated images of Donald Trump marching next to lions and stuff. Like, it's all the same either way. There's not a lot of real people involved in this, so I don't know if he ends up fleeing to that. Honestly, like, they're really fast. There was talk about him creating an actual like media company following his loss in 2020, like starting up a TV news network. He should have just done that. Like, I feel like that could have actually been worth something. I think there are MAGA people that would tune into something like that far more than would actively use True Social. Because again, for a lot of these right wingers, the point of being on a site like that is bothering lefties. But there are no lefties there. There's no one to bother. They're just barking at each other. They're just handing the same poorly generated like memes back and forth. That's not fun. But if it was Trump News, you know, if Giuliani had a show or Nick Fuentes or whatever, I don't know, they'd gather together some neo-Nazis or something and they'd slap a big red hat on the whole thing. That could actually be worth money. And in fact, I think that's probably where this is gonna go.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.